in thinking about language. I think it's exciting to be working in this space now where we're building four African languages, because we're democratizing machine learning. And what that means is that I can start to build for the reality that is around me. My name is Kathleen Siminyu. I am an NLP researcher focused on building for African languages. And I'm also a community organizer, and I've been working to build and support machine learning and AI communities on the African continent. As a data scientist, in my first job, I discovered the gap that exists between Western languages and African languages in terms of language tools that exist. This gap only really exists because people have not focused on building for these languages, which is how I started doing what I'm currently doing. The second hat I wear is as a community organizer, and I've organized with several communities. One of them is called the Deep Learning Indaba. So in 2019, the Deep Learning Indaba was in Nairobi in Kenya. And the two founders of Masakane, who are Jade Abbott and Laura Martinez, came to the Indaba with a paper that they had published. And I will say the rest is history, because I've also been organizing with Masakane since then. Now our membership is almost at 2,500 people, and the research that the community has done it's had great impact. My work with Mozilla was on a project known as Mozilla Common Voice, the platform for building open speech recognition datasets. And it is also a dataset for open speech recognition data. So because the platform is open, literally any individual or community can start organizing and building a dataset on the platform for the languages that they speak. I focused on building for Kiswahili.
Kanda la Kirusi lilikuwa jamhuri.
It was very gratifying to be able to build this dataset from scratch, because often you enter the space of machine learning in general and your work is influenced by whatever dataset is available. So we really were very intentional about thinking about the characteristics that we wanted to be represented in the dataset and to ensure that we balance them out, knowing that imbalances in the data then lead to systems that are biased in one way or another. And at the end of the day, we wanted to be able to build tools that people can use in the way that they naturally speak and express themselves. And I think that this work was definitely a step in that direction. To the Rise25 team and the Mozilla fraternity, thank you for creating this platform to recognize this work and for recognizing my work. I hope to see more information and knowledge access to communities in their preferred languages. And on the flip side, to see more narratives and cultures that are typically on the margins come into the center stage, and hopefully via technology towards more humanity.